Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, welcome. Happy Easter, he has risen.
He's risen indeed.
Thank you. And special welcome to everybody today, but especially to Riley West, making her first appearance at Gloucester Salvation Army after arriving on Wednesday. Tuesday. Sorry, check notes. Tuesday. Yeah. I believe everybody is doing well. You've made it here, well done. Big welcome to Riley and the family today. A couple of dates, 23rd of April, the retirement service of Major Susan Heward will take place here with a buffet lunch after our morning service. There's a list at the back on my left as I look down there for sign up for the lunch, if you get your name onto that so we know who's coming for catering. Also another occasion to eat on Sunday the 7th of May. For the coronation of King Charles III, we will be holding a barbecue in our car park after the morning meeting, a lunch barbecue. Tickets for this are £2.50 per adult and £1 per child, available from Amanda or Jackie. I think that is all except to say happy birthday to Major Susan Heward. And to Kathy.
I share my birthday with Kathy, so happy birthday to Kathy. I don't want all the fuss. But good morning to you all, and a happy Easter from me as well to each and every one of you. We're going to start with Mark's account of the resurrection, Mark chapter 16, and we're going to share together the first 8 verses. And while you're finding that, I'd just like to do a shout out to one of our regular listeners, Doreen, who was able to share with us on Good Friday here. So, love to you, Doreen, and a happy Easter. Mark chapter 16, the first 8 verses. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He's not here. See the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he's going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. Songsters, please come and sing to us.
Thank you. Thank you, songsters. That was really good. I love that song. I almost wished I knew how to dance. You know, just get up and move with that. That would have been really great. We've got a chance for us all to sing now. We're going to sing. The song words are all on the screen. If you've got a Salvation Army songbook, it's 229. O joyful sound, O glorious hour, when Christ, by his almighty power, arose and left the grave. And the chorus, it says, he lives, I know that my Redeemer lived. Come on, let's stand if you are able, and we'll sing the three verses of this great song through. Thank you. About that, the great thing about that is if you know Jesus, you know that he is alive, alive forevermore. Fantastic news. Fantastic news. And this morning we recognize that he is Lord. He is Lord. He is risen from the dead. And he is Lord. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. I don't know about you. Whether you want to kneel this morning, to bow your knee this morning as we sing this chorus. You can sit down, stand up, do what you want. Kneel down, lie down, enjoy this as we just sing this chorus. 222. But quite seriously, if you feel the need to kneel, to bow the knee this morning, and you want to, then do so. Right at the start of this Easter Sunday morning, let it be a time of adoration and worship for our God. And there's the cross, the empty cross. Even if you wanted to come here and bow or kneel at the cross, right at the start of our service this morning, then that invitation is there for you. As we sing together, we pray together, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead. Sing it through again. Then will you kneel and bow before the Lord your Maker, the Maker of heaven and earth? Will you offer him your life right at the start of this Easter morning? Kneel, bow. Raise your hand and say, yes, he is Lord, he is my Lord. He's risen from the dead and he's my Lord. And as we bow, as we sing, as we lift our hearts, let's acknowledge him as Lord this morning. He is we sit here this morning, or as we stand, or as we kneel, as we bow before God, may our prayers of gratitude rise to him, he who gave his life an atonement for the sins of the world, an atonement that we may be one with God again, separated by sin, but drawn together with God through the death and the rising of Jesus. What a glorious Easter morning. Lord Jesus, we honour you this day. We lift you up in our hearts and lives. We confess with our mouths. And what we mean is we just say, you are Lord. You are Lord. And we want to bow our knee before you and honour you today. This Easter Sunday is such a glorious day. When we've reflected on all that you did for us, to go to the cross, to lay down your life, and then to rise again. Father, we just spend these moments adoring you and worshipping you. We thank you for the gift of new life into this fellowship. We thank you, Lord, that a new life is brought safely into the world. We thank you that for many who have lived through many Easters, who have seen this scene portrayed year on year, you are still precious to us. Father God, we thank you for the gift beyond words. We thank you for giving us Jesus. And we pray that our lives may live worthy of that, and we may seek you out and find you for our own personal Saviour. Lord, may this day be crowned with glory and honour and majesty, because you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Rule over our world, we pray, in all its brokenness. Rule over our country in all its brokenness, over our city in all its brokenness, our streets in all their brokenness, our families and our lives and our very selves. May our brokenness be healed. May our faith be strong again. And may Jesus, you reign in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bless you. Bless you. Thank you.
Going to come down here a minute. Children, 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 children. Any other children here? There's some children in the middle. How about children?
Some children over there. Hi. Okay, Andre, you all right? Good man, well done. You gonna smile for me yet? Okay, that's not you, Simon, it's one behind you. Okay, that's fine. Okay, hands up. Who got an Easter egg this morning? Me, I got an Easter egg. Hands up, who's eaten chocolate this morning? Not yet. I don't know about you, I want to testify to the keeping and saving power of God that I gave up chocolate for the entire season of Lent. And I never had chocolate. It was very close. I was very close. I was having lunch with the Rotary Club of Gloucester. I was, and they gave me a chocolate with my coffee. It was very close, and then I was saved by Major Susan and said, "Shall I eat that for you?" At the end of the meeting, okay, I want to see all this artwork. Just saying. I want to see it all at the end. Okay? But I want you to... Are you going to sing for us? Are you going to sing for us this morning, Andrew? Here? There? Upstairs? Right. Anybody who's going to sing with the children, off you go up onto the platform. Ready? Come on. Here we go. Sorry. You want the mic?
Okay, if everyone wants to join me up here, the young ones who want to take part. This one's a bit of an audience participation one as well. It's a bit of a chant, but on Easter morning, all we can do really is really celebrate Christ rising from the dead and being our saviour, and therefore we want to praise the Lord. So you coming up, Freya? Okay, if a couple of you stand this side so that you're not shadowed by the cross there, and then if you three, four, five, six, if you guys want to stand on this side. Okay, so this song is called Praise the Lord. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say to each one of these their name, or ask them what their name, say what their name is, and then we're going to show you how we praise the Lord. What we need you guys to do is to join in. So those who are willing and able, if you want to stand up onto your feet, that would be great. If you're not able to stand, you can do this sitting down. If you don't want to dance, then you can clap. So the chorus bit, which I need everybody to join in on, goes like this. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Let's have a little practice. One, two, three, four. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. So you're ready. So that's the chorus bit, you guys join in on. If you want to dance, you can dance, but you've got to copy what these guys do, because they're going to do it individually. Or if you don't want to dance, you can just clap. Please clap in time. Right. So, hey, Scarlett.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To praise.
Praise who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Scarlett praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey, Isabel.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To pray.
Praise who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Isabel praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey, Seb.
What?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To praise.
Praise who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Seb praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey, Harry.
What?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To praise.
Hey,
the Lord, with your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Harry praises the Lord. Do a little dance. Hands in the pockets, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey, Amber.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
For what?
to praise?
Who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Amber praises the Lord. What dance do you want to do? Point in the sky? Jumping about? Standing still. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey Freya.
Hey what?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To praise.
Praise who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Freya praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey Maddie.
Hey what?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To praise.
Praise who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Maddie praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey, Andre.
What?
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
To praise.
Praise who?
The Lord. With your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way Andre praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Hey, congregation.
What?
Are you ready?
What?
To praise. The Lord, with your hands up high and your feet down low, this is the way the congregation praises the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise, praise the Lord. Thank you. Opportunity to dance.
Thank you, Andrew.
And you may want to stay clear of Freya. She's just passed her first award in karate. Is that right? Oh, sorry, Kung Fu. Kung Fu.
Ah, grasshopper. Excellent. Thank you. Now, come on. You're having a great morning, aren't we? A great morning. Come on and celebrate his gift of love. We will celebrate. It's 357 in the songbook. The words are here on screen. You are going to be exhausted by the time you get to the end of this morning's meeting. Let's stand together and we will sing, Come On and Celebrate. Thank you. I think you need to sit down. I could do with sitting down, but we've got one more song here. The greatest day in history. That's what we're here for this morning, is to remember the greatest day in history. Death is beaten. Jesus, you have rescued me. Sing it out. Jesus is alive. The empty cross the empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day, shouted out, Jesus is alive. I hope many of you know this song. Some of you do? I thought it sounded familiar. Let's sing. Come on. Excellent. Thank you so much. You can sit down now, Mike. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Now we're going to change the mood entirely as the band come and bring to us a piece of music.
Thank you.
band, you could have used that arrangement at the end for our opening song. We'd have quite enjoyed that, but thank you to the band. As it is my birthday, I want us to sing one of my favourite Easter songs. The children are going to leave us for their activity. Now, this is a song that you may not know. We have used it before, 5 years ago. See what a morning, gloriously bright, with the dawning of hope in Jerusalem. It's from the pen of Stuart Townend. Phil is going to help us singing. Oh, is it a bit dodgy, is it? Yeah. But I'll let you, well, if you want to stand, you can stand, but if you want to stay seated, it might be easier if you stay seated, then the people behind you can see the words on the screen. So let's sing together. We've got three verses.
Yeah, maybe you'd like to sing the first verse. Can you stand?
Thank you all. Please be seated. You see, I probably won't get the chance to lead an Easter Sunday again. Sad, isn't it? Anyway, I'm not going anywhere just yet. It's good to celebrate and sing about that first Easter morning. But I'd like, first of all, to take you back a few hours. Did any of them sleep well that night? Would they ever again get a good night's sleep? The mind kept turning again and again as if on a constant loop to the events of that Friday in particular and all that happened in that last week. It was too vivid a memory. The hillside, the cross, Jesus hanging there. How had it come to this? Why had Jesus let Judas stay in the group? If he'd known what was coming, wouldn't he have told Judas to leave? Or done something? He allowed Judas to sit round the table with them. Or was it a case of keeping your enemies close? The tears continued to flow. How? Why had they all run away and failed him in his hour of need? If only they could go back. If only. If only. What if? Could it? Would it have been any different? The hours of darkness ticked slowly by. The women were the first to stir. According to Mark, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Salome. After sunset on the Saturday, when the Jewish Sabbath ended, the shops and stalls would have reopened, and they had bought spices and ointment and prepared them ready to anoint the body of Jesus. For that was women's work. More women with ointment to anoint Christ's body. Just after sunrise, while the grass was still damp with dew, a pale yellow light spreading across the eastern sky, they made their way to the garden and the tomb. There was one big problem filling their minds. Who would roll away the stone? Perhaps surprising that they hadn't thought about it earlier. Yet they needn't have worried, though they weren't to know that. How many times do we get ourselves tied up in knots, sick with worry, and then we discover that the Lord has already gone ahead and rolled the stone of that worry away? Oh, to trust him more. That was what the women found when they came to the tomb. The stone that had sealed the entrance had been rolled away. Did they hang back for a moment, unsure of what they would find? Did they pull their cloaks a little tighter around them? Were they worried that it was the wrong tomb? No, this surely was it. Had the body been moved? Which, according to John's Gospel, was Mary Magdalene's concern. In John 20 and verse 13, she says, "They have taken my Lord away, and I don't know where they have put him." As the light of dawn increases, perhaps gingerly, they enter. And what a shock awaited them. There sat a young man dressed in white, very much alive. "Don't be alarmed." They'd nearly jumped out of their skins. As their racing hearts slowed, he spoke again. "I know you're looking for Jesus the Nazarene, the one they nailed to the cross. He's been raised up. He's here no longer. You can see for yourselves that the place is empty. Now on your way. Tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. You'll see him there exactly as he said." The women didn't know what to think. And the Message translates verse 8 as, "They got out as fast as they could, beside themselves, their heads swimming." What would your reaction have been in that situation? Forget for a moment what you might know about Christ's resurrection and his appearances to the disciples. Would we not too have been shocked, stunned, and frightened? If you visited the tomb of a loved one and found it empty, what would be your reaction? What was going on? The women fled and said nothing to anyone. And that is where Mark's gospel originally abruptly ends, almost mid-sentence, as if the last chapter of the story is missing. If you look in your Bible, you will find that another 12 verses have been added, believed to be by another author, added later to finish off the gospel. Many ancient manuscripts do not have these added verses. The style of writing and phrasing is different. The verses summarising what we know from the other Gospels. Mark's was the first Gospel written, and we don't know why he originally ended so suddenly. Perhaps persecution interrupted him. Perhaps the ending got torn and lost. We don't know. But the story can't have ended there. The women were afraid. They didn't say anything to anyone. Would anyone believe them? Would they be blamed for moving the body? In other Gospels, it was the case that nobody at first believed the women, not until they had been to the tomb and seen for themselves. In Matthew's Gospel, there were guards at the tomb, and they were bribed to say that the disciples had stolen the body. In Luke, the disciples don't believe the women, and then Peter gets up and runs to the tomb to see for himself. And in John's Gospel, chapter 20, Mary Magdalene goes and tells Simon Peter and the other disciple, and they ran to the tomb to see for themselves. And then there is that beautiful encounter between Mary and Jesus, who she mistakes for the gardener. Whatever happened to the end of Mark's Gospel, the word did get out and started to spread. Jesus had risen from the dead. His followers saw the risen Lord with their own eyes. He was greater than death himself. Hope and belief were restored. But there are two things I'd just like us to consider in response to Christ's resurrection this morning. Firstly, there is the miraculous and there is carrying on. There is Easter Sunday, and then there is the rest of your life. The tomb is empty, so what's next? The stone had been rolled away from the entrance to the tomb. Are there stones that need rolling away in your lives? Stones that would keep us trapped in the ordinary humdrum life we are living. Perhaps people have said to you, you're not good enough. You failed before. Why should now be any different? You'll never be able to achieve what God is asking of you. Perhaps you've convinced yourself of that without anybody else saying it. You doubt your ability. I haven't got what it takes to do that. It's as if we spend life trapped in a tomb because we won't allow ourselves to find the way out. The way out is open. Jesus rolls away the stones of doubt and belief if we will just let him. Instead of being, I can't, it becomes, together, we can. Jesus and me. That's the truth. The stones have been rolled away, and it's not just for today. For Easter can be every day. Will you allow Jesus to roll away the stones that hold you back? Gideon Hugh, who has written in his notes for today for Tear Fund's Lent devotional, says this: the world is out there, open, full of invitation. The angels are sitting outside, waiting for you to take those steps beyond the threshold, not just of the empty tomb, but the threshold of whatever holds you back. You are not what other people have said about you. You are not those things you said about yourself in the dark nights of your soul. The stones have been rolled away. The doorway is open. Step out. And keep stepping out as many times as you need to. Easter is always. Roll away that stone for yourself today. And the second thing is this. Mark ends abruptly. The women went out and told no one because they were afraid. But they must have told someone eventually. But as you go from here, or wherever you are as you listen to this, after we have sung our Easter praises and heard again the events of that first Sunday, who are you going to tell? Perhaps not necessarily today, but as this week unfolds, who will you share the story of Jesus with? I know I said that the last 12 verses we have of Mark's Gospel are a later addition, but in verse 15, Jesus says, "Go into the world, go everywhere and announce the message of God's good news to one and all." This message is not just for Easter. It's not just for Sundays. It's for every day and everybody. Go tell the world the tomb is empty and the stone is rolled away. Go tell the world. Go tell the world. We're going to sing song 237. All heaven declares the glory of the risen Lord. I don't know if any of you saw the sunrise this morning, but the second verse presents a challenge. I will proclaim the glory of the risen Lord. Do you need to respond? Who are you going to tell about Jesus? Or do you need to come and bow at his feet and ask him to roll away the stones that hinder your life? Let's sing together and make your response as God leads you. Let's pray together. Lord, as we sit bowed before you, we worship you alone, the risen Lord. We thank you for your gift on the cross of Calvary of salvation for each one of us. But we thank you too that you rose from the dead, and that you promise us eternal life to live with you. Lord, we may feel timid and scared, but help us this week to go out and to tell someone about you. The women were initially afraid, but they must have gone and told somebody, and then when you started appearing to the disciples, they knew it was true, that you were risen. And we thank you, Lord, that you are still in the business of rolling away stones. If there are things that hold us back, obstacles that keep us from doing what you want us to do, that hinder us, Lord, help us not to be upset by things people say, that they may put us off and make us think we're not worthy. Roll away the stones, Lord, that we may see you face to face and know the strength that your Holy Spirit gives to enable us to do the things that you want us to do. So, Lord, as we shortly go from this place, go with us. Risen Lord. Amen. Now, I guess there's a song that if we didn't sing it today, you might never forgive me. It's song 218 in the songbook. The band are going to help us, and we're going to rise to sing, Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's rise together and sing the five verses through.
Sounds of heaven.
final prayer together. Thine is the glory, risen, conquering Son. Endless is the victory thou or death has won. No more we doubt thee, glorious Prince of Life. Life is naught without thee. Aid us in the strife. Make us more than conquerors through thy deathless love. Bring us safe through Jordan to thy home above. We bring our Easter praise to you, Lord, and now we go out into the world to share that news. God bless you, each one. Amen.